Okay, I'm back, and hopefully you guessed properly that we're going to be using a motion block to get our cat moving forward once we're pointed in the right direction. When I add this block called Move 10 Steps, you can see that right away my character starts moving across the screen. Every time your cat spins around this loop once, it's going to move the default 10 pixels. Here's a chance to customize. Try putting a different number, higher or lower, into the move block and see how it changes your game. We don't want to make catching mice too easy, so I'm going to tell the cat to move a little slower at a speed of 6. It's your game though, so you can pick whatever number you want. We've only added 4 blocks so far, but some of you will have noticed that our game is already glitching. Everything looks good while I'm cruising around the screen, but as soon as I stop moving, this happens. The game's not broken. The trouble is we've given it confusing instructions. We've ordered the cat to always face the mouse cursor, no matter what happens. But we've also told it to keep moving forward 6 steps at a time, no matter what happens. So when the cat actually accomplishes its mission and reaches the mouse cursor, it just keeps blindly following its instructions because we haven't coded it to do anything different. It moves forward another 6 steps, then realizes that it isn't facing the mouse cursor anymore, so it flips around to face it. Then it moves forward again, realizes it's gone too far, and flips again, and so on, and so on, and so on. So our cat is just going to keep flopping around like this until we solve our problem. Let's try a different approach. Pull the 2 blue blocks out of the forever loop and replace the forever with a new kind of control block called repeat until. The repeat until block works very much like the forever loop. It will keep following the instructions that are inside of it over and over again, but with one twist. We're going to add an extra instruction inside this loop that tells it to stop working when my cat touches the mouse cursor. To do that, we need a special light blue block from the area called sensing. Sensing blocks work just like your own human senses. They give us information about what's happening in the little virtual world outside of our sprite. You might have noticed that there's a little dent in the repeat until block that's shaped just like our sensing block. Drag the block that says touching mouse pointer over to the repeat block. When it gets really close, the dent starts to glow white at the edges. If you let go of the block now, it will pop right into that spot. Now let's run the program and see what happens. You can see that our cat is still chasing the mouse cursor, but when it gets there, it stops working. The program has accomplished its mission, so it exits the loop and continues on to the next instruction. This isn't going to be part of our final game, but to understand this better, let's add a new block that tells the cat to talk to us when it reaches the mouse cursor. Go to the block category called Looks and grab a block that says Say Hello for 2 seconds. I'll edit the block to make it say, I did it, when it reaches the cursor. Notice that I'm putting this block outside the loop because I only want it to run after the loop has finished. As you can see, as soon as he touches my mouse cursor, the cat breaks out of the loop and moves on to the next command. You can go ahead and delete the say block if you added one, because it really doesn't work with our game. Okay, we solved our glitching problem, but we have a new problem. Our cat stops following the mouse cursor, and now it's just sitting there. What we actually want to do is restart this loop again every time it finishes running. Let's pull all this code back inside the forever loop. Now, every time the repeat until block has finished its job, it will loop around and start again. Voila! We've solved all our problems and we're done programming our cat. Go ahead and finish coding the cat to match what I've just done. You know you did it right if the cat is following your mouse cursor all the time, and if it doesn't glitch. When we return, we'll get started on our mice. 3, 2, 1.